Hey, what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to another Genshin Impact video. Today is a quick one where I hope I can make it quick. I'm going to be talking about Kazuha's banner. As you guys know, Kazuha's banner is coming in just under 10 days, 9 days, 12 hours for EU. But I just wanted to talk about if it is actually worth summoning for him, where he'll fit into your team, depending on what kind of player you are. Do you guys even have Primogems for him? Did you summon for Klee? If you did, it might be a good idea to not summon on the banner. That's if you're a free-to-play player. If you're pay-to-win, you're probably not even watching this video. I'm just asking, is it worth summoning for him? Well, I'm gonna state a few points first. First point, I don't have him currently. I can't tell if he's worth it or not. But who I do have, I guess I could compare it to, is Sucrose. Sucrose is incredible. She scales off elemental mastery. Well, she doesn't scale off elemental mastery, but whenever you level her up, her ascension stats, whatever it may be, it's animal damage. It's not even elemental mastery. But you can build her for elemental mastery because of her talents, because of what she does, and you kind of want elemental mastery on her. And she performs incredibly well for every single scenario. Obviously, this is my second account. This account doesn't have her built just because, well, you know, I want to build Kazuha. And Kazuha is going to be really good. He's going to be excellent if you were going to build him for a support, or I guess some people want to build him for DPS. I don't see why you would build him as a DPS character because he scales off elemental mastery. His whole ascension stats are elemental mastery. Obviously, you could go for something else, but I don't see it being as powerful. Obviously, you could say, oh, maybe I could build him off attack or crit or whatever it may be. And yeah, you are right to some degree. But if he scales off elemental mastery, just build on the elemental mastery. He's going to be really good. I guess in a way, the support build could be, you know, labeled as a sub DPS. Because you could switch to him, use his elemental skill, use his elemental burst, and then switch out. And with that, you're going to provide damage, you're going to provide whatever it is, but it is also support. You want to use his elemental skills, you want to use his elemental burst and dip, and then go to your main DPS. Your main DPS could be whoever may be. On this account, for me, it's Tartaglia. He could fit anywhere. Because of this new elemental mastery buff, because of this new swirl buff, he can fit anywhere on any team. You don't need to have two animal characters on your team. You just don't. You could run just him and, you know, just plaster him in any team. Right now, I'm running Tartaglia, Zhangling, Fischl, and Jean because this isn't the team I've built. I could replace Fischl. I could replace Zhangling. I don't think I would replace Jean. Just because she is my healer as well. So I could replace two characters on the team already. Just because, oh, he's an enabler. You can allow Tartaglia to use Hydro and you can do Hydro Swirl. You can use Fischl and Fischl can do the whole Electro-Infuse Swirl. Or you could use Zhangling for the Pyro Swirl. Everything works. Especially for a support character. And I just think it's an incredible build. He's going to be a 5-star support and I'm really excited for that. And I feel like a lot of people don't realize that, oh, there's way too many 5-star main DPS characters, right? You've got your Hu Tao, you got your Zhao, you've got your Tartaglia, you've got your whoever it may be. And the characters that really stand out for me are the support. Zhongli. Zhongli is an incredible 5-star support. He's the best in the game, in my opinion. I'll always say that. And me saying that, it like says a lot. Obviously, Gan Yu, incredible because she can be the strongest character in the game for DPS, or she can be an incredible support. She can have, you know, have her ultimate be out and she can cause melt or vaporize all the time. Not vaporize, but freeze all the time because her ultimate is up. And I feel like that's really, really, really good. That's why she's an excellent character. That's why she's a top tier character, right? These characters are characters that can be support. And I feel like that's not talked about enough. For example, Bennett. Bennett is also one of the best characters in the game just because he allows you to get the attack boost. He allows you to get healing. He just does so much for the team. Not to mention, if you have him C1, it's just really good, right? So, is it worth summoning for Kazuha? Is it worth using your gems on Kazuha? Are you saving up for Kazuha just because of this? Because of what I said? I hope so. But I would skip Klee for Kazuha just because I don't have that many supports. Especially support 5 stars. All that said, is it worth summoning for him? In my opinion, he's really good. In my opinion. And having a character that can do that for you, can be very versatile. You can have him on your team, in any team. Just provide that animal support, the elemental mastery support. It's pretty good. It's nice to have, especially in the new Spiral Abyss. Obviously, every new Spiral Abyss is catered towards a new character that comes out now. They did the same thing with youll with the physical damage bonus. Now you've got your 300% sword reaction bonus, and that's going to be really good to have with Kazuha. He's going to clear floor 11 by himself. Kazuha is going to be incredible. I already have his weapon prepared. I have his artifact set prepared. I'd say it's very worth summoning for him. But is it worth using your getting a multi on him if that's all you have? If you only have 10 wishes or 10 pulls, I wouldn't say so. His banner might not have the 5 stars or 4 stars you want. So if you can get him on guarantee, you should get him. Anyways guys, I hope you guys did get something out of this video. Am I going to be summoning for him? Yes, I'm going to be summoning for him on this account. Watch out for that video. It's going to be coming as soon as he's out. I'm going to actually be streaming it on my YouTube channel. And if I don't stream it, it's going to be a video. So anyways guys, I hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, consider liking the video as well, subscribing to my channel. I hope you guys did enjoy it as well. See you guys in the next video very soon. Goodbye.